Welcome to the Referrals Podcast, the show designed to help everyone from the solopreneur to the Fortune 500 company win the referral game. If you want to build a company with an army of ambassadors and raving fans who speak highly of you and refer you willingly, you are in the right place. And now, here is your host, Michael J. Mayer.
Hey everybody, this is Michael J. Mayer with another edition of the Weekly Wow, Weekly Words of Wisdom. And what are we sharing words of wisdom on today? Getting listings in today's market. I don't need to introduce it. I don't need to hook you. I don't need to tease you. It's getting listings in today's market is the number one challenge for realtors. And we have an expert here today to explain how to get listings in the hottest market in decades. And I will tell you that this speaker was one of our top rated speakers at our recent Referral Mastery Summit. And by the way, you can get the recording of his presentation plus 30 plus more at referrallibrary.com. You open it up, it says RMS 2020. You can buy all the recordings, and this has to be a misprint, right? For $197, that's actually not true. You can actually use the coupon WOW, lowercase W-O-W, and get all of the recordings for $50 off because you're listening to this episode today, period. Now, I will tell you, if you're watching the recording of this, if you're watching this later, that deal may not be there. So I just want you to know, referrallibrary.com, click on RMS 2020, the class, the course, and then for $50 off, you can get all of those recordings, and one of those is by this man right now, Paulie Dominich. He is one of the top rated speakers from Referral Mastery Summit 2020. He is a certified referral trainer. He is a certified evenings coach and taught Sweet Dreams with yours truly and Tara Carter. And Paulie Dominich is a licensed real estate agent out of the Emerald Coast beaches of Fort Walton, Florida, covering Fort Walton and Destin. He's only been licensed for 5 years, people. 5 years, but rose to the top of his company quickly. And he recently became the father for the first time of Elias. That is his big why. And he lives by the motto, be kind, remain savage, and change lives. Welcome to the Weekly Wow, Mr. Paulie Dominich.
Thank you for having me, Michael.
All right. So do I call you Paulie or do I call you Paul? Right. I've only done a million things with you. And it's like, all right, now it's Paul Dominich. Like, what is it? What is it? What do you want to be called?
It's Paulie all day.
Yeah, Paulie. Like, Paulie's my friend. Like, Michael.
I'm your guy. I'm your guy.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, Paulie's my guy, you know?
Guy.
So, all right. So I have to tell you, this is the number one challenge for 99% of the agents out there. They are in markets where, you know, they would almost buy to get a listing, because with the listing, you're going to get multiple offers. The seller's going to be happy. Even the buyer's happy that gets the property. So you're dealing with happy people. The people who aren't happy are the 12 offers who didn't get it. And those buyer's agents have to go deal with upset people, you know? So listings are where it's at. They say you list to last, and they say old realtors don't die. They just become listless. Dun, dun, dun. And in this case, we don't want to become listless. We want to have listings. So first and foremost, tell us about your market.
Yeah. So the market that we're in right now is extremely tight, and it is a competitive market. So there is low inventory with the low interest rates, and we've got a large VA community here because of the military. So it's even more difficult when having to deal with offers, because a lot of these VA buyers are 100% financing. So now when you've got somebody that's coming through with some sort of financing, that no longer is something that is going to be appealing to the seller. So the moving of the military, we're still moving. The military is still working. So that's creating a shark tank for buyers right now, which is why it is super important to make sure that you are focusing on getting the listings and what you need to do to get the listings today, but not only today, but in the future, right? So all of your actions today will lead to productivity down the line, even if you don't get something today. But if you focus on trying to think about the scarcity of it and I need it today, what's going to end up happening is you're going to feel like you're on a hamster wheel and then you won't be productive.
So true. And so it is one of those where sometimes in today's world, our actions today in real estate will pan out in 30, 60, 90, in some cases, 900 days, you know? And that's the power of all this. There's very few get rich quick schemes in real estate. There's most of the time when it comes to real estate, patience is a virtue. And if you're into instant gratification, you're probably going to struggle in this industry. But if you're willing to do the work and you're willing to do the little things that lead to listings, then guess what? You're gonna get listings. I mean, that's what's great is we know what you're about to share with us works because you're doing it and a lot of other people are doing it because of you. And we know that what I will share works because I've been doing it for 20 years and it's always worked and it will always work in the future. That the question remains is are the listeners, are the people who are watching this willing to do the work? Are you willing to do these little things, put out a little effort, maybe a little money and a little bit of time and energy to get the listings that you need? And the problem is a lot of agents are spinning their wheels. You know, they're in the same market that we are in, similar wise, but they're just spinning their wheels. They seem to be chasing their tails a lot. Any advice for the agent who just seems like I've done all these, I've done 20 of these, but you know, I've never gotten a listing from any of them. Any advice for that person? I know that's not one of our scripted questions, but I know you can answer anything. So,
questions, what are you talking about? Chris and your script. You know, that is the biggest part of my motto with remain savage, right? So that's where that remain savage part comes from. You be kind, you create that positive energy, that attractive personality. Then you've got to remain savage with the consistency. The consistency is what should be your motivation, because there's going to be days where you're going to be down. You're not, you feel like you're doing everything, but nothing is happening, right? But if you stay consistent with the systems, especially the 7L system, which promotes growth and generosity, and you stay consistent with it, it will happen. The fruit will grow. You can't just put a seed on concrete and have it grow. You've got to plant the seed in dirt. It takes a little dirt to grow. And when it starts to grow, you have to nurture it before it brings you fruit. If you try to pick it too soon, it will die. You must let it grow. And that is really, truly what the 7L system is all about. It's how to go from a seed into a fruit-bearing tree. But you have to be consistent with the watering and the nurturing of your relationships, and also you as a human being that's becoming that attractive personality. You have to have that. So the growth also is, think of it like human development for yourself. So not just growing in real estate, but also just growing as a human being and as a person. Because in real estate, we're here to help people achieve one of the most amazing things that they can possibly achieve, or even something that they didn't think they could achieve. And being part of that growth in somebody's life in itself alone is just greatly rewarding.
Yeah, I love what you said about self-improvement. Being attractive attracts listings. It really does. It attracts sellers. Sellers are attracted to success. They really are. You know, buyers are attracted to availability. And so we need to be successful, or at least have the habits of the successful to get listings. If you're not confident in yourself, then guess what? Why would a seller be confident in you? You know, a buyer just wants availability. They just want to see the homes. They want to get into the homes. They want available information so that they can make a decision. Availability is your key. But on the listing side, it really is success. Like, how many have you sold before? What have you sold before? What's it look like? And that's what I love about the strategy that you're utilizing in today's market. And before I get into, you know, what are you actually doing to get listings, I want to do two things. One is, those of you that are watching this Facebook Live right now, and you're listening to the recording later, I want you to tell me, how did you get your last listing? How did you get your last listing? Like, mine was referral, which makes a lot of sense, but we've gotten listings other ways. But it just so happened that we had a referral from my sister that turned into a listing. But here's the thing. How did you get your last listing? And the second thing that I have to speak to is exactly what Paulie's saying. There's a lot of people out there that say, you've got to be a hunter. You've got to be a hunter. You've got to chase it. You've got to chase it, and so on and so forth. And the problem with hunting is you kill it and then it's gone. And what do you got to do? You got to go hunt some more. You got to go kill something else. And then there's people that say, you've got to be a farmer, right? You got to be a farmer. You got to have corn plants. You got to have wheat. You've got to farm in your area, farm. And the problem with farming is you also kill the plants. And then what do you got to do? Replant the seed, rewater it, re-nurture it. And you're reinventing the plant every single time. The thing, the mindset of the generosity generation, the mindset of the 7L system is, you are growing fruit trees. If you're in Florida, it's orange trees. If you're in Georgia, it's peach trees. If you're in the western part of the state, you're apple trees, right? You might be pear trees. I don't know. I don't care, honestly. But think of it as, here's what happens when you have a fruit tree, is you nurture it, you water it, you let it grow. It grows up big and strong. And then guess what? All you got to do is go pluck the orange or the peach or whatever it is off of it, but the tree doesn't die. Ladies and gentlemen, and here's the beautiful thing too, is that if you don't pick all the peaches, some of those peaches are going to die. But what you can do is, before they die, you can take them, you can plant those peaches otherwise. Those are the referrals. Those are, you know, that's why we do the great retrace, is you've got the peach, you got to retrace it to the tree, right? And that tree had a source that was another tree, and we need to make sure that we keep track of that. So this is about, you know, you might want to call it a grower or being an orchardist, but really the easiest thing to think about is, man, have a grove of trees, and these are your army of ambassadors. They will help you get your next listing, right? So let's get into that. So what are you doing to get listings in your marketplace right now, Paulie? You've got two or three things you're doing.
Yeah, so I've created like a little strategy. So a little step by step to get to where the strategy itself actually works. So there is some sort of preparation that I've done to get to where my strategies are actually bearing fruit. And that's number one. The thing is that I'm gaining super clarity on my value proposition. What makes me worth the commission rate that I am getting? What am I providing that all of these other agents are providing? But then how am I capitalizing on getting the exposure that's going to get them the most amount of money in the shortest amount of time? So you have your exposure, right? But then what is your strategy to increase that exposure to gain a positive net profit that's going to make your seller excited, inspired, right? Then engaging in conversation about that. So making sure that I'm having those conversations with that, about that value proposition. I'm talking to my team about it. I'm talking to my past clients about it. I'm talking to my mom about it. I'm talking to everybody about it, and making sure that that excitement stays all the way throughout, because the more you speak about it, the more you believe it. It's not a sales pitch. This is what's going on. If you could tell your mother about it and how you're going to sell your mom's house, then there is no sales pitch there. You know, this is what's best for her. So by practicing that and making sure I've got that engagement, right?
So let's talk real quick on that, right? So let's go into, I love that you said, I mean, a lot of people talk about coming up with your UVP or USP, unique selling proposition or unique value proposition. And some people, I think a lot of times you see a blank stare on a lot of agents' faces or lenders' faces, like not sure what my value proposition is. And then the other part of it too is to articulate it. And what happens is, I'm guessing, like with you, your value proposition has changed the more you articulate it, right? You become better at articulating it the more you articulate it. And it's almost like you're practicing on everybody until you get to the person who really needs to hear your value proposition. And all of a sudden they're like, oh, you know what? I need your services, right? What is Pauly Dominich's value proposition? How are you different than all the other agents in the marketplace?
Yeah. So here's what everybody does. Everybody's going to put your house on the MLS. Everybody's going to take the professional photos. Everybody's going to do the Matterport. Everybody's going to do the virtual tour. These are the things that agents should do to maximize the exposure. But when it comes down to the strategy on how I'm going to get the people that are going to engage in your home, that are like more likely going to sell your house, that strategy comes with informing the people in the area, the direct area and the community that house is for sale, with a coming soon, a blitz in the box, a property package that's going to have all of the insurance, the utilities, the taxes, so that no questions are asked, all the age of the major appliances. So when we put that out, that's the strategy, because the exposure is just seeing the house on the internet. Right? That's it. But then when it's like, okay, we go to the house, great. It's the same as the next house. So what I do is I create this property package where you know everything about this house, that when you leave my house, you know the age of the roof, all of that. They go to the next house, they're like, hey, what's the age of the roof? The agent's like, I don't know. And I also make sure that I make the other agents look like rock stars.
There you go.
So I make sure that when the property package is done, I say, hey, check this out. Go to the backside. There's documents. Download that. That has every single thing you need to know about my property. So now when that agent is in that house and the buyer says, hey, what's the insurance on this property? They go, oh, it's going to be about this much for the next 6 months. So now all of a sudden they become very knowledgeable about the market, which makes the buyer's agent feel great, which makes the buyer have confidence in that person.
There you go.
And then all of a sudden, now I've created a relationship with a lot of the other agents in the area as well that are pushing the listings that are coming my way.
All right. I'm the seller. And you just said what you said. I'm getting it. I'm feeling it. Right. And then, all right. So something that triggered in my head, and this is so good. You guys all need to have these phrases that you own and almost trademark, but they become a signature of you. You said blitz in a box. Mm-hmm. So what is the blitz in a box? That's unique to you, right? And I'm telling you, the seller, here's what the seller is doing. The seller's going blah, 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 blitz in a box, blah, 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 rotten chicken, right? So it's like, what is the blitz in the box? I want to know.
Right. So the blitz in the box is my actual farming sequence that I do. So
okay, let's hear it. I want to know this. Everybody, get your freaking pencils ready, your paper ready. I've got it ready. I'm ready to learn, right? So all right. I love this. What is the freaking blitz in the box? And it's a blitz around the house. I love this. All right. So tell me more. Yep. This is actually a little bit even new from RMS. I'm liking this.
Yeah. Yeah. So the first thing that I do once I get the house under contract, I do an inspection and I take a coming soon picture of the house. With that coming soon picture of the house, I make a Facebook post. I make the Facebook post and it does not have the address of the home on it, just the area that the home is going to be in with the square footage and some of the features.
I've seen these. They're good.
So I share that with all of my marketplaces. So that right now just puts it out there as a coming soon. That's like the new iPhone 12 that just came out. It just came out. Everybody wants it. Where did you get it? We just saw it last night, but people are lining up right now. So that creates that engagement. Then what we do is in that area, we send out a coming soon letter. The coming soon letter does not say, hey, this house is coming on the market. Do you want to know the value of your home? No. Why are you creating competition for your seller?
Boom!
They don't want to hear that.
That's awesome.
The language is, hey, this house is coming on the market. Do you know of anybody that you would like to move into your neighborhood? Please contact me for a private showing before it goes on the market. Mm. Now that gets sent out as a coming soon.
Yeah, there we go. You're working for your seller instead of working for yourself, brother. That's the answer.
Sellers love it because when you say the talk track is, look, this is what they're going to do. They're going to try to get the house across the street. They're going to try to get their other signs in this area. I don't want another sign in your neighborhood unless they call me directly, but not from the marketing of your home. I want to sell your home first, then get another listing so that I can maximize the market value that I got for your home for that listing as well. So I want to use your listing as a come up for the next listing that I get, not try to sell both of them at the same time, nor create the competition. So I ask people, do you know of anybody that you would like to move into the neighborhood? Mm. So that's the second one. The third thing I do is we then do the coming soon on the MLS, put the sign in the yard, and then we do it on Wednesday night is the coming soon. On Thursday, we make it active. And then due to COVID, we are not allowing any showings on the house until the first open house is done on Saturday from 11 to 1 so that everybody has the opportunity to see the house at the very first time at the same time so that we can clean the house properly for you, seller, to ensure your safety. This prevention.
Wait. You're cleaning the house?
Yes.
What? So this is like a COVID-19 safety protocol, aka.
Yeah, we're wiping down the doorknobs and everything to make sure that all that stuff is squared away from them. You know, that is a thing right now. And look, it is serious. It is a serious thing, right? But just because it's serious does not mean that we shouldn't leverage this in our marketing. This is definitely something that somebody takes seriously, and we should be doing this to people that might not even take it seriously. We should take it serious for them and their safety. So this is a value proposition that you should be presenting to your sellers. So now what ends up happening is you also talk about what this prevents is you getting calls on Friday and having to set up appointments every half hour on the hour and being out of your house all Friday, all Saturday. You don't have to worry about that. Come Saturday, that's when everybody will come, they'll see it, and then we'll have some showings thereafter. So that creates that line, and we're getting 20 people at these open houses just like that. And then also when we do that coming soon, we are sending a letter out saying, hey, house is on the market. If you would like to know, if you know anybody, this is a little bit different. So we were, this is good. We were door knocking, but I would pull back the door knocking. But when we allow door knocking again, this is where the blitz in the box is coming in your door.
So let me go back. So you're doing coming soon, and you're doing coming soon signs that are custom. They're unique to that property. They're unique to you. And so these are all coming soon signs with a picture of you and a picture of your sign on it. Oh, how about you just show one, right?
This is pretty much what it is. This is a postcard, but everything has my picture on it. Nice and big on the side. That's all it says. Coming soon.
All right. So there's like 50 of these things all the way around the house. And then you've got coming soon on the sign in the yard. And how, okay, so you're across, how many people in the neighborhood are getting like a coming soon notification?
So we notify the entire neighborhood.
Okay. At this point, all right.
Because okay. We want everybody to know that this is going on. So okay. When we do the door knocking, it is, we've changed it to a piece, but the door knocking and the piece says this, and this is the language.
Yeah.
We are doing an open house. Do you know of anybody that you would like to move into your neighborhood? And, or if you would like to know the value of your home, please stop on by.
Okay.
This is a safety announcement to let you know that there will be extra traffic in your area on Sunday from 1 to 3. And we put a blue safety first stamp on the letter.
Yeah, so very attractive.
We're not just being a real estate agent. We are being a community safety guard to let you know, keep your dogs inside, your kids, there's going to be extra traffic while we're there. And now when you re-engage them again for doing another open house, it's not just the letter that says, hey, we're doing another open house.
Right.
It's, hey, I'm notifying you again that we are doing this. Thank you so much for accepting my letter and allowing me to be your safety real estate agent in your community.
Yeah, so you're the safe guy. You're going to do it the right way, right? You're the safe guy. You're going to do it the right way. And it's one of those where I want everybody to note what he covered a lot of ground in the last 30 seconds. So the first part is coming soon signs that are custom, not the little ones that you buy from MLS, right? Mm-hmm. These are custom coming soon. Why doesn't every realtor out there, if you're listening to this, go buy yourself 20 to 50 corrugated plastic custom signs that say coming soon with an arrow on it and point them all to the house that's coming soon. First of all, it's going to generate a lot of, and it's not just your little pointer signs, right? It's coming soon. It has an attraction to it. Put an exclamation mark after coming soon. And then, so the coming soon and then a coming soon announcement goes to the neighborhood and it's all coming soon. Like, you know, pre-launch. And then, when Paulie does an open house, he has the signs look exactly the same. They just say open house exclamation. And they're the exact same sign, but there's 20 to 50 of them up. He is notifying them by letter. Now it used to be a personal notification that, hey, traffic's going to be up. We're having an open house. You're welcome to come by. And come by if you might know a buyer or you want to know the value of your home. And here's the other part too that, you know, Paulie, what time are your open houses?
From 11 to 1.
11 to 1 on Sunday. Do you ever do a sneak preview for the neighborhood people, like a 10 to 11 or do a sneak post view like 1 to 2, that way you're there for sure, right? Or your agent's there for sure.
Doing that when we were door knocking.
Yeah.
But now that we're not door knocking, we're not creating, I didn't find that to create that much engagement.
Yeah.
So we are just doing, holding it back until 11 to 1. That's what it is. Before we used to be able to get people excited and say, hey, but this is what's happening. Bring your people by before we do the open house and we'll let them in. And then that way you kind of get a jump on it if you like it. So yeah. Creating that engagement. And that was all, that's also, guys, everything that you're doing, you're not necessarily trying to get somebody in the neighborhood to find the buyer for you, but you're getting them excited about hiring you in the way that you are engaging them, right? So how you're engaging them and telling them, hey, do you know of anybody? They're going like, oh, this guy is trying to find somebody to buy the house across the street. I want that guy that's going to try to find somebody to buy my house as well. So this is an open house. This has just turned into an open house.
Yeah. Yeah. So you're getting 20 to 30 at your open house. Your seller's thrilled. You're getting offers, multiple offers, sometimes unrepresented offers, and everybody's winning. Everybody's loving it. And so, Polly, here's what I love about this. I mean, you are a big part of the generosity generation. And, you know, we've recently kind of like, this has become the tribe of trust, right? And the tribe of trust is, it is a tribe of people that we trust, and we can trust everything within the tribe. And what I love is that I'm not afraid. You know, I've been in situations before as an interviewer, as a person who asks the questions. I'm afraid to ask certain questions because I don't know where the BS starts, right? What I love about you is that I have 100% confidence to ask you anything, and there's not going to be any BS because you're doing it, and you're doing it thoughtfully. You're doing it with intention and purpose. And like you know this stuff, right? And you're doing it. That's what I love is you're not telling me about stuff. Hey, well, you know, here's what I did in the past, but you know what I'm really excited about is what I'm doing in the future. And it's like, we don't care about what you're doing in the future. How the heck did you get your last listing? You know? So it's one of those where I love that. You cover. And so first I have a question on the open house. 11-1 on a Sunday. All right. So what's the science to that? If there's any, is it just traditional in your area? Why not 1-3? Why not Saturday? Why not Thursday night? You know, I'm just genuinely curious here.
Right. So when I do the 11-1, what it allows is it allows people to set that schedule where they don't have to worry about the other open houses, the 15 other open houses that are going on from 1-3. So when they come to my house,
God, that's genius.
Take their time going through my house instead of running through it to get to the next one.
That's genius.
It makes sense. And especially after church ends at like 10:30. So it's like come right after church, they go through the house, they'll grab a bite to eat, then they'll end up going to the other open houses. So I've just created that success because I figured people are rushing to get into all of these open houses. If I can create a time where nobody else is doing it, there's an advantage there. And then
after the open house is over,
if they want to go see my house, they just schedule it after the open house is done because it's open.
Do your open houses when others are not doing theirs. Too many people get into the traditional mode. It's like, all right, open house Sunday, 1-3, open house. Now you're doing these on Sunday. Yes.
Sunday
and sometimes Saturday.
Oh, Saturday for sure. And Sunday.
Okay. Same house.
Same house.
Oh, I didn't know that. 11-1 on Saturday and Sunday.
No, we don't play.
Oh yeah, you're okay. Listen. All right,
feelings don't put food on the table. Action does.
Oh yes, they do. Yes, they do. Yes, they feelings. That's all we are is feeling human beings. All right. So here's the thing, right? So here's the thing that you're the agents out there. You're looking for a unique value proposition. I'm telling you right now, that you could go into a seller and tell them that you are going to do open houses on Saturday and Sunday until it sells. And A, you would be hired on the spot probably. You instantly have a unique value proposition is that too many lazy realtors out there. I mean, especially in today's market, they're super busy. They can't promise an open house one day. I mean, there's a lot of agents who don't do open houses, which I think is insane. I think it's, somebody says, hey, I'd like you to set up, you know, free a retail store at my facility for a couple of hours during the week. And you're going to say no to that? It's like, no, you need to look at it like you're launching a grand opening at this person's house for 2 hours. And that's exactly what Polly's doing here is first you got to go in. If you're talking to the sellers, I love the idea of Saturday and Sunday. Many times that has to be the thing where they're like, oh, that's awesome. The other person was saying they're going to do one or whatever. And the other thing too, Polly, is because you have a system that's set up for multiple days, you could say, you know what? We'll have it open Thursday night, 6-8. We'll have it open Saturday. We'll have it open Sunday. And we're going to have it open till it sells. It's like, that's genius. And you're getting buyers and you're getting more listings.
Yeah, and here's the thing behind this, right, guys? It's not just setting up an open house. This has to be an event, right? So back to, okay, we're doing an open house seminar a little bit, right? But here's the thing. I always tell my team and myself, we are not in the open house business to get buyers. We are in the open house business to get referrals. If you set up your open house to where it gets your seller excited about what you are doing and how you are presenting your house, you know what will happen? The buyers will come. It will just happen that way. But if you do not set it up like that and you do not get your seller excited, then there is nothing to get buyers excited for to come to the house. So start right and you will compound and synergize the success.
So good.
The seller will refer you.
So that good.
Is the money.
Yeah, drop the mic. I mean, like, so many people are doing open houses to get buyers. So many people are doing open houses to get sellers. Polly Dominich is doing open houses to get referrals from his seller. He is keeping the number one, the number one. And that in itself is huge. So how are you pleasing the seller? You know, too many open houses are like, they're like, oh my God, they're like, they're all like fishing. They're like, I'm trying to think of like great. It's almost like bringing hogs to slaughter. You know what I mean? It's like, but what you're doing is you're keeping all your focus on the seller and pleasing the seller. So what are you doing? Maybe one or two little things that you're doing to make sure that you please the seller. And here's what's so cool about this. You're pleasing the seller and it's actually attracting more buyers and sellers. This goes so back into the bike, right? It goes back into my bike speech, where it's like the back wheel is lead with generosity. Put all your effort in generosity. The generosity cycle will turn, which instantly leads to the referral cycle to turn. The front wheel is the referral cycle. And it's like, always keep your guide, always keep your focus on, does this get me referrals? And if you focus your eyes on that, then the referrals will come and everything else will come. It's literally the perfect metaphor for the bike metaphor. I love it. So what are two or three little things that you're doing differently? Sorry to interrupt your answer there.
So what we're doing is we're making it exciting. You know, I got flags. We put flags out there so that the neighbors know, holy cow, this is what's going on. We make sure that we're prepared. So we have that full package that I was talking about that has all of the features in the house. And as people are walking in, we say, that is your opportunity to talk to someone. How you doing? Welcome to my open house. I've got a package here for you. Let me just show you some of the things that are in this package that can help you purchase this home. This is a lender's flyer. This is what the insurance is. This is the taxes. This is the layout of the house. This is the age of the major items. And we go through that. So now you've got a reason to stop people as they're coming into the house. They look at it. They're very impressed because now they have all of that information there. Your tag is on. They're looking at you going like, okay, this is the guy. And then you catch and release with, if there's any questions that you have, please let me know. If you need a net sheet done for the home to know what it's going to cost to own the home and your real estate agent doesn't know how to do that, I can help you with that. Are you working with a real estate agent that knows how to do a net sheet? Because I can also send that to them if you would like me to.
I hope everybody caught that.
Objection of, do they have a real estate agent right there, without being all creepy and weird about, do they have a real estate agent?
That's another drop the mic moment right there. That's the script of the day right there. That's the phrase that pays for all of you. That phrase is going to pay all of you. Use it. does your agent do what I'm about to do for you? I could do a CMA for your home. Does your agent know how to do a CMA? If he doesn't or she doesn't, I'll send it to him. Do you have an agent who knows how to do a CMA? Well, we don't have an agent. Okay. Or yeah, you know what? Let me check with her. Okay. There we go. Boom. So
weird. It's not creepy. You're not following. You catch and release. Now you already know that they're going to come back to you because they have all of that information. And the thing is that on the last sheet, guys, this is important.
Of the net sheet of your
of the package of the open house package.
Yeah.
Last sheet comparison, house one, house two, house three. So when they leave your listing and they're writing the comparison, is this a 10? It says score the rooms to 10. Mm-hmm. They go to the next house that has nothing to do with you. They've got this score sheet. They score that house. They score the next house. Honey, it's Tuesday. We were looking at those open houses. What do you think? Let's look at that package. Find that package. You know, we didn't like the house that Paul had, but that second house is really nice. We love this house. Who do we call? Oh, we'll call Paul because it's in Paul's package. They wrote the information down on the package that you provided them. So now you're capturing them again. And what do we talk about when we're talking about listings and or buyers or anybody in this industry is creating value, not just being the guy. Because here is the thing. This is what happens in real estate. The person closest to the contact gets the contract.
Say that again.
Present value. You will always get beat by the person that they just met, that they had a drink with, that happens to be a real estate agent. If you have not created enough value, it happens. The person closest to the contact gets the contract. And that's why once you present your value, you must have a follow-up with the clarity and the engaging conversations and how you transfer your value on all of the platforms to stay top of mind awareness to continue to generate listings and buyers.
So good. So good. So good. The one closest to the contact gets the contract. Get close. Proximity is power, right, brother?
Proximity is power.
So I will tell you, everybody, that I hate to end this because I have like 1,000 more questions, but we are right on time, just over time, actually, for our typically weekly WOW show. But I wanted to, I actually shared this on my main Facebook personal profile as well. And interestingly enough, Babs Brenton, who is Howard Brenton's widow. Howard unfortunately passed away. Babs Brenton and Howard Brenton and Babs Brenton were the parents of Star Power Stars. And what's interesting about that is some of the most fond memories I have in my life centered around Howard and the Stars. And Paulie, you're a star, dude. You're a Star Power Star. You fit in 110% with the energy, the knowledge, the mastery, the sharing, the heart, the humor, the articulation of what it takes to become a Star Power Star. And I'll tell you, this has been a phenomenal, I mean, literally a pearl a minute type of conversation. And I've enjoyed every minute of it, brother. Appreciate you.
I appreciate you and the generosity generation. And I was grateful for Kim Gwen, who actually gave me a call and said, hey, listen, you've got to come check this guy out. I came to your CRT. I didn't even read your book. I had no idea. Even after the first seminar, I was like, where are the seven level? Where is it in the book? I still couldn't find it, but I stuck with it. And it's like, what? Yes, I stuck with it. And then finally one day, it's like a light bulb. It's like everything that you know that you need to do to just create personal growth and relationships, but it's the way that you put it together. And then all of a sudden, when you get it, it's just amazing. And that's what I've got to let people know, guys, like consistency. Don't let motivation be a factor. Let your consistency and your discipline be what drives you to success, because it will happen. It will, if you take the right steps and you believe and you stay within this generosity generation. Man, there are so many giving people here, and I'm just so blessed to be a part of this. And I want to say thank you very much to all of you in the generosity generation, and also you, Michael, and for everybody that you guys have over there working and allowing me the opportunity to share and be a part with you and ride as a right-hand man and a mentee. And thank you for being such a great mentor.
Awesome. Well, it's easy to mentor, right? I mean, like I just, here's the thing. I just got to get out of your way. And all I think I do sometimes is help you get out of your own way. Yeah. That's the only thing, right? Just get the heck out, he's speeding. Like, just get out of the wake, baby, because he's going to be coming. So I love it. I love you. And I appreciate you very much. And this is just so good. And I will tell you that if you would like to hear interviews like this that we just did at Referral Mastery Summit, you can go to referrallibrary.com and look for RMS 2020. Get all 30 plus 18-minute breakouts, all of them. This is crazy. For not $197, which is what we sell it for, it's actually $50 off if you use the code WOW. You might think, wow, they're making some money here. No, listen, that's the cost of putting this bundle together. We just want to get this information in your hands so that you can make a change. The entire concept of Referral Mastery Summit was best year ever. We only interview people who are having their best year ever. So you can have your best year ever. And the things they overcame, the challenges they faced, the turmoil that they saw and still had their best year ever will release any limiting belief that you may have. And also be on the lookout for details on our upcoming Notevember challenge. That's right. It's no longer November. We're calling it Notevember. And we're going to have a 30-day challenge associated with the Notevember that is going to blow you away and increase your business coming in November, December. And it's probably going to have a residual effect in January, February, and March to start the year. So this has been the Weekly WOW with Michael J. Mayer and Polly Dominich. Polly, once again, thank you for being our guest on the Weekly WOW.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. I can tell you that this will be uploaded to the Referrals Podcast. You can check that out at referralspodcast.com. So you never miss an episode. You never miss any live that we do. All of them are uploaded there. And then please rate and review it. And please share it if you like the Referrals Podcast. We appreciate all of you. And we'll see you next week on the Weekly WOW.